Today, I'm going to show how to resize, increase or decrease AWS EC2 induced platform. Here we see some step. Now I'm going to step number one, logging AWS console. Just write aws.amazon.com. Just click on sign into the console. Just click on select root user and put the email address. And here I put the password. Just click sign in. Now I am going to the step number 2. Stop instant and check availability zone. Check availability zone. Just click on service and select EC2. And go to the instance. Just here see, you can go to from here, but just go to the instance. Here we see this is my Windows VM and it's running, and this is the availability zone is AP South 1A. This is the most important when you resize. You just remember is AP South 1A. Just I am copy the AP South 1A. And check availability zone. Okay, stop instance. Now I am going to the stop instance. Just click on stop button. Just yes. Stopping. It takes some time. Okay. Instance status has been stopped. Now I am going to the instance ID. Just copy this one. Just here you see instance ID. Just I copy this one. Just copy and paste it into here. In future it will need. Now I am going to the step number 3. Go to the volume and check size and attached information. Here you see, just go down, just see the volume. This is my volume. Volume is 30 GB, and volume attached information, this is the most information for everyone. This is the dev.dev.hda1. Just I write here dev.hda1. In future it will need. Now I am going to the step number 4. Create snapshot and copy snapshot ID. Just here create snapshot. Just select this one and click on action and create snapshot. Here I just put Windows VM. Just click on create snapshot button, already created. Now step number 4 has been finished, and now I'm going to the step number 5. Create volume as you desire. You right click. Just I am going to the step number snapshot, and here you see this snapshot is pending. It takes some time to you see snapshot status has been completed. Now I am just copy this one snapshot ID. You just snapshot ID copy and put it into here. Now I am going to step number 6. Create step number 5 has been finished. Now I am going to the step number 6. Create volume as you desire size by clicking on the snapshot. So in snapshot, select this one and go to the action and go to the create volume. Here we will increase the 50 GB instead of 30 GB. Just I write the 50 GB. And availability zone, previously I said the availability zone AP South 1A, it's already here. Just I am going to create volume. It is created. You see, just go to the again volume. You see two volume is there. One is the 30 GB and another is the 50 GB. Okay. Step number 6 finish. Now go to the 7. Go to the volume and detach previous volume by right click. And now I am in the volume and select the previous volume 30 GB. And go to the action and detach the volume. Detach this volume. it also takes some time and it's depend on the size. Okay, detest has been complete. Just you go to the here, status available. Available means detest has been completed. So now I am going to the right click on new volume and select attach volume. So just this is the new volume 15 GB and right click the attached volume and instance ID. Previously I write here instance ID. This is our instance ID. Just click on and put here. This is my instance and device. This is the previously I wrote the partition information. Just copy this one. Just attached. Click on attached. Okay, it is in use. That means it is attached. Now I am going to step number 9. Turn on a Windows VM and extend your disk. Just I go to the instance and this is my Windows. Go to the start. Click yes. Initializing. It takes some time to initialize. Okay. Status check has been complete. Now I am going to the login. Just go to the here you see this is my IP. Just go to the remote connection. Administrator. Just put password. So here just I go to the this PC. This is the 30 GB. Now I am going to the create and hard disk format partition. And here we see the 30 GB and add more 20 GB unallocated already. You just click on the C drive right button, extend volume. Just click next and 20 GB in mode already selected. Just click on next and finish. You see hard disk size is 50 GB. Again you go to the 50 GB already is there. So now I am going to step number 10. Delete your previous volume. So here we see in the volume section two volume. One is 30 GB, another is 50 GB. Just I select the previous volume and go to the action and delete volume. Already deleting. It takes some time to delete. The volume has been deleted. Now I am going to again go to the snapshot and here we see snapshot is 30 GB. It's also need to be deleted. If you want, just go to the delete option and delete it. Okay, thank you for watching my video. If you need any question, please let me know as soon as possible. I'll be back. Thank you.